The final ceremony of the environmental sustainability competition was attended by leaders including Maria Hankson, the Swedish ambassador to Uganda, Antonio Querido, the FAO ambassador, among others. The students showed a high standard during the discussions on how they can save the environment.
COVID-19 situation, we saw what came in. We saw that the scientists brought about the numbers, and before, even without lying to the people, you saw the action that the people made. Because we think that mindset change is actually something that is actually going to help us in as far as climate change is concerned, in as far as making sure that we promote awareness among the citizens, in as far as recycling is concerned, and in as far as reducing the littering rate is actually concerned.
Peter Muhereza of the Office of the Dean of Students at Makerere University, on behalf of Professor Barnabas Nawangwe, praised the quality of presentations made by the students on saving the environment.
The teachers that have taught these students. I see Kavoyo from Mengo, a future prime minister. I see Bambale swearing in here at Makerere as a guild president and beyond. I see very big personalities in these debaters. And to me, that's very, very important.
Javez Njanabo, the deputy managing director, thanked those who sponsored the project to reach its completion. He also thanked all the schools that participated in this competition.
Weeks where they have weeks and months to prepare. And these students you saw here, these fine students, had 10 minutes to prepare, and they had such fine debates. Of course, this is not just an event of the debate. This is an event, as explained at the beginning, that marks a kind of the end of the first round of a long process that we all know is aimed at combating all the evils of climate change.
Antonio Querido, the Food and Agriculture Organization's representative in Uganda, praised the quality of debate and the students' performance during the competition.
Some questions were quite tough. Some of the learners were given some difficult positions to argue. But we have seen that they are capable. We have seen bright and clever minds developing. So your voices are important. The voice of young people of Uganda are important, and we strongly believe that this platform is also provides an opportunity if we are to develop policies, programs for sustainable development.
Tom Okello, the head of the National Forest Authority, said most of the unprecedented falls in the world are caused by environmental degradation.
We are seeing unpredictable rainfalls. We are seeing flash floods. We are seeing landslides. We are seeing drought. We are seeing so many other disasters. And this points towards our actions on mishandling the environment.
The ambassador of Sweden to Uganda lauded Vision Group and schools for championing the Green Schools initiative to engage learners in the fight against climate change.
Well, this is the first year, and we have another to go. And of course, as with all initiatives, you have to constantly evaluate and see how you take it forward. But I think, today's new vision, I also saw that there was strong interest from Ministry of Education to take this forward across schools in Uganda, and of course that's what we would want to see.
The champions of the Green Schools Project 2023 is Sacred Heart SS Moshanga, secured the gold medals and an impressive grand prize of 10 million shillings. Mengo SS emerged at the first run-up. They proudly accepted silver medals and a remarkable prize of 7.5 million shillings. Reports compiled by Winnie Apollote for the news.